81 times of itself. Now let us look into the statement 1. The sum triples every 4 years at compound interest. Now initially let us take that the sum as P. After 4 years it is becoming 3P, which is triple. Next, this 3P will be considered as principal amount for the next 4 years. So after next 4 years it will be triple again. That means 3 times of the principal, which is 3P. Now it is 9P. Then this 9P will become 3 into 9P, that is 27P. And after that it will become 81P. By counting this number of 4 years you can answer this question. That means you can answer this question by only statement 1. Now let us look into statement 2. Rate of interest is 50%. Rate of interest is given as 50%. Now let the sum be some P. And amount after 1 year, let us say. After 1 year this P will be increased by half P. So this will become 3/2P. Like this, if we calculate the values, you will get the rate of interest. You will get the time for which it will become 81 times. Or we can use something like this. Initially let the amount be P. After certain number of years, say T, it is becoming 81 times of P. So initially it was P, now it is 81P. So there is an interest of 80P. Now you know the interest as 80P, you know the rate of interest as 50%, and also you know the time as T. Now by using the formula I is equals to PTR by 100, we can calculate the value of T. That means we can answer this question by only statement 2. So we can answer this by 1 as well as by 2. So answer is C. Average speed of Ashok, whereas he has traveled from A to D, which stops at B and C. So he has traveled from A to D and he has stops at B as well as C. Now let us consider this statement 1. It says that the average speed of Ashok for AB, BC and CD are 20, 30 and 40 kilometers. Now we know the individual average speeds, but in order to find the average speed of the entire journey, it is nothing but total distance by total speed. Now from statement 1 we don't have any information about total distance, so we cannot answer this question by statement 1. Now let us look into statement 2. The total distance between A and D is 100 kilometers. So the distance between A and D is 100 kilometers, but we have no information about the total speed. So as we don't total time, as we don't have any information about total time, we cannot answer this question by only statement 2. Now let us combine them. Now if I combine both the statements, from the second statement we know the total distance, but what about total speed? We can find the total speed if we know the total time, if we know the time between AB, BC and CD. Now in order to find the time in the interval of AB, we know only speed, but we don't know what is the distance traveled. So as the distance is not known, we cannot find the time in the first interval, second interval, as in the third interval. And also we cannot find the total time. If the time is not known, we cannot find average speed. So we cannot answer this question by only statement 2 or combining both 1 and 2. So it is answer D.